Halo, selamat datang kembali ke di Jakarta Crossover bersama gue Rena. Dan hari ini kita main setelah 2 minggu lagi. Emang susah sih ya kalau mau main. Tapi udah player udah 6. Tapi kalau DM-nya emang gak bisa ya mau gimana lagi.
Wait, 3 minggu gak sih, Re?
3 minggu ya?
2, I think 2 minggu off.
2 minggu skip, 2
minggu
yeah.
Off yeah. 2 minggu off. Ya yeah. I'm so sorry. But let's see, mungkin kita ntar juga gini juga udah akhir tahun juga ya. Let's see. We will finish this adventure.
Oh, eventually.
Eventually. We will be there.
Oh wait, it's
eventually.
We will be there. How long will it take?
Ganti tahun lagi. Ya?
How long will it take? We don't know. We will end it next year. Hopefully. Jangan 2024, oke. Okay? Oke. Okay, nanti Atta bakal Bandura bakal join. Kasih tahu gue aja ntar kalau dia mau join. Harusnya sih bisa langsung join ya harusnya. Tapi ntar kasih warning gue dulu biar gue siap. Biar hati saya siap ya. Hari ini gak ada siapa namanya? Oh,
Love.
Sebentar. Tidak ada Vatslav. Gue baru nyadar di video ini overlay letak video gue sama letak videonya selain kebalik, tapi ya sudahlah. Show must go on.
What? Why?
Iya.
Yes,
video Legend Master video.
Yaudah, Den, lo yang nge-DM Den hari ini, Den.
Iya, Den, lo yang nge-DM Den ya.
The City of Kresk.
In the City of Kresk. Iya. Tapi gak apa-apa lah.
I need my own carrot.
Gak apa-apa lah. Tapi yang jelas, let me recap what happened 3 weeks ago. So, CC41. The CC40 itu sekarang. Terakhir kalian akhirnya sempat ke Crash, dan sampai ke Crash kalian sempat ngobrol sama ada guardnya situ, basically sudah kenal sama Rafael, udah berapa kali ketemu, jadi dia bantuin kalian buat ngomong sama Burgomaster, dan akhirnya setelah kalian coba convince Burgomasternya, which his name is Dimitri Kreskov and his wife Anna Kreskov, you talk with him and then he eventually let you inside the Crash. The great city, not the great village of Crash. And then when once you come inside, you find out that this this village is kinda gated community, kinda isolated. And you can see that inside there are a lot of trees because they grow their own foods. But yeah, terakhir kan Strat masih ngamuk-ngamuk ya. Senang Strat mengamuk. Kehidupan di Crash agak lontang-lantung. You all decide to go to Kreskov Mansion, so not mansion, Kreskov Lodge. Jadi sini rumah-rumahnya dari lodge itu ya, rumah-rumah dari kayu-kayu semua, like a wooden lodge. And then you decide to go to Kreskov Lodge. You talk with Anna and then barter with them, and then you got some potions, I believe.
We did magic turn wine into
to normal to greater, yeah.
Yeah.
To normal to great with wine.
And then, yeah, and then you trade it with wine from the Wizard of Wine. And then while you talk that in the house of Kreskov, Balfan, you found in the Kreskov Mansion, sorry, Kreskov Lodge, there are portraits of the previous Burgomasters. And then Balfan, you found out that one of the Burgomasters was this lady that you notice as Anya from Ivan's memory, but according to the Burgomaster Kreskov, her name is Sasha, and then she's kind of like, I don't know, kemarin tuh kubilangnya apa sih si Sasha? What did she do?
Like she sacrifice?
Yeah, she sacrifice herself.
Volunteer.
To...
Yeah. Volunteer. Yeah. Go to the devil.
Yeah. So volunteer herself to go to the devil, so the Crash village will be untouched by the devil himself.
Gue lupa, dia ada nama belakangnya gak ya? Yeah.
She married to Kreskov family, so she becomes Sasha Kreskova, but before that, her name is... dia bukan dari keluarga Kreskov aslinya.
Okay. But we still don't know the.
But I don't think sih. I don't think okay. They tell you, but they tell. They already told you that Sasha was not from Kreskov family. dia married to the family. Okay, and then you talk. Somehow you kind of suspect that according to the people, the village people, that the broker master just lost his son. But when you were there, you kind of hear this giggling, child giggling and stuff like that. And when you ask, itu gak mau minta bantuan Embed, Dmitri Kaskov mengalihkan pembicaraan ke arah Rafael dan dia bilang, iya gue ngeliat lo, gue ingat dulu ada tifling di rumah di sini namanya Faith and her companions. And then terakhir Rafael nanya, do you know what happened to the baby, the child, and then we end it right there. So let's take over from there.
Kita
langsung outro. Okay guys, kita lanjut dari situ ya. Sebentar, ganti musik ini aja, musik kalem. Kalau musik ini main, apa yang terjadi? Tidak akan ada pertumbuhan darah. I just want to remind you that ini ya. Nah, crash itu kemarin kan juga nggak bom nggak ada ya. Kelihatannya seperti ini. Okay, also terakhir bom. I will say you probably will love the Burgomaster because Burgomaster is dia tuh pria apa sih, like middle aged man. Gak tahu tinggi tapi bantet gitu loh badannya, bantet berisi. Terus pas ketemu sama kalian tuh dia bawa kapak, istrinya sampingnya bawa shovel gitu. So dia looks like kayak mereka bergumasar kan chief character, kayak strong chief. Kemarin si Bomom juga nawarin teh ke mereka. Nawarin
teh. Oh, did I?
Yeah.
Did it work?
Yeah. Sorry.
It's like your chief type gitu loh.
Yeah.
Oh, I see.
Lo gitu. Dia kan bener, iya, so
Chief material.
I mean, yeah, he is basically the chief of Crest. He is the chief of Crest, and then he look strong, old but strong. Okay. Okay, so let's go back to the session. So right now you are still in the Kraskov Lodge, living room, talking to Dmitri, and then Dmitri just asks Dmitri about, do you remember what happened to the child? Terakhir itu kan.
Yes.
And Dmitri said, Kraskov said, ah, the child, yeah. It's been a while. It's been years. And if I'm not mistaken, there was this baby. I mean, more like a toddler, really, a toddler. And then, I just remember what I can remember of them is, at some point, two of her companions, I don't remember their name, a human and the people with
horns,
with apa namanya, with like kind of sharp ears.
Oh.
You know, like the people in the yang di tadi itu near. Talaki, what's name? Terus dia bilang, oh I believe they're
called the Fistani Cam.
I believe they're called Elf Deer. Oh yeah, that Elf. And then they were gone for a while, like 4 days. And then when they came back to our village, they were in a hurry. And then I remember that day so vividly because suddenly I think you noticed that this land is surrounded by mist, right? But during that day when Faith and her family flee from Crest, the mist was gone. I don't know what happened. And then they just try to flee from the village, but according to our guards, according to our hunter, when they were trying to run away from, I don't know, from this village, or they're trying to go to tempat yang dulunya ketutupan sama Miss, our hunters and our guards saw a pack of werewolf trying to chase them. and I don't know what happened to them anymore. Well, that's not really wrong. See, some hunters, they find some body parts mangled, and they decided to but they found body parts and then mangled, and then they broke it to San Markovia IB to be buried.
I don't know. I think.
But I don't think they found the child's body. Just only the adults. So I don't know what happened to the child. Yeah, and also not long after they were found, I mean the miss was back. Jadi buat nih, jadi jelas pas mereka mau kalian keluarga lu kabur, ini misi sempat hilang gitu, jelas misi sempat hilang, mereka kabur terus ke dijar werewolf dead tanda tanya.
Oke, Bavan, kenapa tuh?
Kita tahu nggak sih kalau ini your mom?
Yeah, that's what I want to
maybe
ask.
Maybe only me.
Oh, sorry, Bavan, gue nggak lihat resenya, sorry ya.
No, it's okay. Yeah, do we? I don't know.
If you yang baca,
I don't think we have the time to.
We haven't.
The one Eric recovered was I recovered the letter, right? And I gave it to Rafael.
But you didn't tell anyone.
I haven't. Yeah, I haven't told anyone.
Yeah,
anyone yet. Only Rafael.
Okay.
I know, right?
You should know.
Yeah, I think so.
In that case.
Well, you know what? In that case, Rafael, why don't you roll me at a? Let's roll your history.
Okay. History, okay.
Because after Rafael roll, I wanna do something, right?
Sure. Let's see. So your history and got a 13 with ini.
The die rolls.
If I can guide, use guidance then with guidance.
Iya.
Kalau nggak bisa yang
ini lu juga ini ya. Magic lu juga divine magic ya. Jadi ya, I don't think Kraskov will be alarmed. Paling kaget aja. Tapi ya it looks your magic looks good. Gak aneh-aneh kayak
the magic looks good.
Ya, I mean magicnya saudara teman kalian si Paslap itu kan agak mencurigakan ya. Okay, with 13, I guess Rafa, when you hear that story, ya matikan musiknya sedikit biar dramatis, you have this blurry vision in your mind, like the vision of you running. You are running towards this woods, ke hutan, ke forest. Dan lu ingat hutannya waktu itu tuh pohon-pohonnya kering. Kinda reminds you of the trees in the edge of Barovia. Dan saat itu lu lagi menggenggam tangan seorang wanita bertanduk, kulitnya kayak rutan. Lalu cuma ingat dia kayak ngeliat ke lu. Dia bilang apa? Basically si wanita ini bilang, "Rafael, tetap pegang tangan ibu. Jangan dilepas. Jangan lihat ke belakang." Terus lu cuma lihat kayak lu lagi lari berdua. Dari depan lu lihat ada dua orang lagi. You do not see their face, but the four of you are running. Dan di belakang lo dengar suara kayak derap langkah kaki beberapa, satu pasang, dua pasang, 10 derap langkah kaki mengejar kalian.
Okay.
That's what you remember.
Okay. So, what is the graveyard you said in San
in the Abbey?
Oh yeah, they were buried in the Abbey.
Okay. Is there any, I don't know, names or in their stones?
For your mother, probably.
For the names, your mother, I don't, sorry, bukan mother yang tahu. Oh, so the ladies, the tiefling ladies, she called herself Faith, and her companions, the humans, his name is Bradburn, and the other one, I think he said that he's an half elf.
Half,
yeah. His name is Paul's Grave. Tulis ya. Faith. Bradburn. Sama Paul's Grave.
So I can find their names in.
Yeah, you should.
The graveyard. Okay. Thank you for the information.
Mr. Dimitri.
Yes.
Speaking of the graveyards, is your youngest also in the Abbey? Like, we would like to, you know, but like pay our
respects.
Yeah, and.
Terus saya kayak ngeliatin tuh mukanya kayak
insight check.
Ken.
Yeah. Probably.
Yeah.
Wait, I don't have the insight.
I don't think I have guidance, right? If I do, it will be like, fuck, yeah.
I don't know what to guide myself to. Ooh, nice! 21?
Yeah.
Ooh.
Oof,
Rafael. Oh, never mind. I'm still too shook.
Yeah. Si Rafael, you're still too shooked after you hear about
shooked
this woman, and then you got this memory, that lost memory of your early childhood, probably. It's very.
I think I'm also looking at Rafael.
Yeah. So, looking at Rafael. Yes, oh.
I think I know what's going on.
Yeah. Oh, the tea is hot. And then
this we take.
Yeah, Balfan, you zone in into Preskov's face, and then basically you the first thing that you can see is it's more like unease gitu dia kelihatannya. Unease, agak nervous. Dia enggak, tapi dia enggak ada tanda-tanda, enggak kelihatan dari body language-nya, dia enggak kelihatan hostile atau dia kelihatan kayak mau keep a secret atau apa, tapi dia kayak nervous gitu, kayak bilangnya kayak kasih tahu enggak ya gitu.
Okay.
Probably with gentle persuasion you can make him talk maybe. Dia kayak lagi diambang kebimbangan.
Hello. Hi Dimitri.
I mean, like, what can I say when I'm
sorry.
Yeah.
Hey, Om, kita udah Om.
Well, only if it's okay with you, of course. It's just that you know, with the apa namanya, Paladin of siapa? Morning Lord or something.
Morning Lord.
Lu paladin apa sih? Kok jadi lu?
Paladin apa? Mater.
Oke.
Mater.
Iya. Maybe with the, you know, the paladin especially can offer some proper prayer and lending offer, you know.
Okay. As for this,
only if it's okay with you, of course. We don't mean to intrude too much, but.
Yeah, so it's actually good that you mention your friend is a paladin, even though Kreskov knows nothing about Illmater, and then he can tell that you all do not have any ill intention. So I will allow you to roll me a persuasion.
Okay.
Karisma lo ngambil satu.
Okay. Plus satu.
Okay, that's good. Okay, Morten is good.
Yeah, okay.
Terus dia lihat kayak kan di situ kan sempat masih ada sempat gue lupa tak kenapa ada di sini atau tapi aku saya akhirnya ada terus si Kreskov di
sini. Dia kabut terakhir.
Yeah. Oh terakhir kabut dia si Ana ya. Dia kayak ngeliat sisinya nggak ada kan. Dia langsung menghela nafas panjang. Okay. I can tell that you are. I think you are good for people, and then I will take a gamble, and I'm telling you this. Please do not tell anyone else about what I'm going to tell you. Okay.
Okay.
Your friend has mentioned that. Gue lupa kemana nanya siapa. I forget who asked me, but do I want the abbot's help? Well, it is my belief that the dead should not be disturbed. Let the dead, you know, pass on, move on. It isn't my belief like that, but my wife has different opinion.
Well,
I cannot fault her. We have lost our children before this, and then in her grief, when the abbot came to our house to visit and offer his service to revive him, to revive our son Alan, she agreed despite me not wanting to do that. Well, if you want to find a grave of my son, you will not find it, Mr. Balfan, because he was already revived by the abbot. But here's the thing is, he act exactly like my son, but I, you know, with what happened in this land recently with House the Devil corrupted this land, and it's very hard for me personally to find any semblance of divine power in this place. I'm a bit skeptical of the miracle the abbot performed in my house. Mr. Raphael, you said that your friend said that you are a paladin. Does it mean that you know about any divine power? Can you perhaps check if my son is okay?
I can try.
Okay.
I cannot really guarantee anything, but if it, I don't know, somehow can help you.
Okay. So I see, Bafan,
to know.
Yeah.
Wait.
So basically, Bafan, even though his voice sounds agak datar, tapi lu kayak lihat ya mukanya agak sedikit ada perasaan kebapaan yang tolong bisa cek anak gue baik-baik aja atau enggak gitu. Walaupun suaranya agak he's a Borgo master, dia biasa kalau ngomong dikontrol kan, kontrol emosi.
Anyway, I see him like buried all out gitu kan ya, berarti yeah. Ya, he keep nothing, so I will be like, am I right to presume it was the one, he was the one you were talking to?
Yeah.
Di sana tadi like.
You hurt him. Yeah. Okay.
Itu sorry Ren, tempat yeah. yang gue denger tadi itu like is it another room
kayak
upstairs?
Di luar, kayak di luar gitu loh, kayak di depan pintu. Gitu, kayak di luar, cuma di luar aja, di luar koridor aja, enggak tahu jauh, cuma tadi ya. I send him back to her room. But... Okay, just wait here, I'm going to call him. Yep. Just please check so I can be ya bisa menenangkan hati orang tua ini gitu. Dia pergi sebentar tuh. Sebentar dia pergi
yeah, I'll probably, okay, sure.
I'll probably whisper to Balvan like do me need to prepare weapon?
Yes. Terus gue whisper balik, that's my secret. I'm always prepared.
I will slowly take out like the silver great axe and put it beside me like plunk.
Terus si Esmeralda kayak ngeliatin lu. Well, I think that your axe will terrify the boy. Maybe just umpetin sedikit ke belakang. Like,
oh sorry, great sword.
Great sword. Umpetin sedikit. Lo lihat juga si S tangannya juga udah kayak gerayangan di hiltnya, papiernya gitu loh.
Sasuga, senpai.
Udah yes, gerayangan maybe, gitu loh kayak.
Maybe another stage of preparation make me the best.
We need to be subtle.
Okay, subtle.
Yeah, you remember.
I will resheath it yeah, and take out the javelin while say subtle.
Bom. Should you guys chill out?
Just imagine if you go to your chief house and then you see people taking their weapon, it will not be good, right? Chief, the chief will be angry, right? If you do that, the chief Kreskov will be angry with you. More subtle.
Need to maintain face.
Yes.
Okay. I'll just drop it on the ground.
Bing, drung, terus main pas
klontong,
klontong, terus berbarengan itu juga si Kreskov masuk sama ada satu anaknya gitu masih kecil, kira-kira umurnya masih 7-8 tahunan gitu kali ya. Mukanya cakep gitu lah, mukanya cakep. So probably yes, mungkin kalau lu lihat kan dari foto-foto keluarga Kreskov gitu kan pas mereka masih kan di paintingnya pas mereka like in their big
prime
age gitu kan, prime age gitu kan. Ya kalau bisa sih keluarga Kreskov sih ya cakep-cakep mukanya, cakep-cakep. Mungkin karena si Dimitri udah tua dan stres gitu di bawah penderitaan pemerintahan Strat gitu kan, mungkin karena ada potensi tanaman layu gara-gara serat ngamuk, jadi dia lebih stres gitu kan, jadi mukanya kurang enak dilihat. Tapi pas lihat si anak ini mukanya baik, bagus itu sih, kayak bersih, tipikal anak-anak yang mukanya bersih, bercahaya gitu. Terus matanya berbinar, tapi pas lagi masuk dia kayak ngumpet di balik kaki bapaknya gitu kan. Terus si bapaknya, si Dimitri bilang, come on Alan, say hi to these people.
Hi.
Okay, I'll cast Divine Sense.
Divine Sense. Poof.
What's your name?
My name is Alan.
And pas tu cast Divine Sense, poof, immediately you sense nothing. So he's not an undead.
Okay,
I'll start packing my weapon again.
Oh, you start packing your weapon again?
Packing.
Oh, packing, okay.
Masukin
ke dalam. Oke. Okay. Oh, udah packing aja.
Okay, so according to your defense is okay. Terus awalnya mungkin karena S kepo, si S kayak mendekatan gitu kayak hai, kayak baik-baik gitu kan. Gimana kabar? Namanya siapa? Hai gitu-gitu kan, mukanya ramah. I think it's fair if ini ya kalau melihat.
Oh sorry, pencet.
Kalau melihat apa yang terjadi gitu tuh, I think it's fair ya kalau dia mau coba kayak cek secara lebih dekat with medicine. It's fair lah ya, kalau si SK gitu kan dia kepo. Kalau ada yang mau ikutan
bagi. Sure. Kan, I think
I'll
go behind us ya with everyone. I think I'm also interested in the start.
I'm just confused on how to deal with small people. I don't know how to deal with small people.
Oh my fucking god, ask why your role is
a curse. Oh my lord.
Why your role is a curse?
Wait, itu enggak di help, Ren.
Tadi di help ya?
Yes.
Dia kan. Okay, so I think we all like looking around.
14 ya berarti. 14. I think 14 with 14. Indeed. I think with 14, she can tell that he looks okay. I mean, he doesn't. I mean, you already confirmed that he's not an undead. He looks okay.
But.
Upon closer look, she noticed that his kayak gigi taring itu agak mulai agak lebih panjang gitu jadinya. Agak sedikit lebih panjang gigi taringnya. Sama, dia juga notice di buku-buku jari, di buku-buku jari gitu kan, kalau buku jari kita kan ada rambutnya gitu kan ya. Punya anak sini rambutnya agak sedikit lebih panjang, agak sedikit abnormal gitu.
Oh shit.
Dia bisa tahu udah bilang tuh. Menurut anatomi manusia gitu kayaknya umur segini enggak segitiga bakal sepanjang ini gitu. Gitu ya.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Alright. Anyway, while S and like Rafael was investigating that, I'll try to ask anybody like Dimitri or Anna and say, did the abbot perform this miracle free of charge, or did he ask for anything in return?
It's free of charge. He said that it is his calling as the follower ya, as the servant of the morning lord. Okay, while this happen, Bobo, you can kalian bisa tuh kayak keluar gitu. If you want, you can roll perception.
Also, si Ananya nggak di sini kan?
Ana lagi nggak di sini.
Okay.
Karena ya, you can tell that probably Dimitri make some bullshit excuse for Ana for not being here. Cek Alan.
It's 12.
Okay, that's surprising. Interesting. The abbot is very generous in that case.
Okay, so before ntar lu belum pernah ke Valaki, gue lupa. Sepanjang di sini lu cuma ketemu ada kayak Raven bertengger gitu di salah satu rumah, nggak terlalu jauh dari rumahnya Burgomaster si Raven dengan ini. Yang ekornya tuh ada warna birunya sedikit, so you know that Muriel is keeping an eye on you. I will say, momom lu udah kasih tahu tuh Muriel siapa ya. Jadi kan lu tahu kan ada Keeper of Feather, Fair Raven. Muriel tuh salah satu Wear Raven yang ditugasin sama The Martikov buat paling nggak keep an eye gitu, buat bantu kalau if you need help. Basically kalau if you need Wear Raven help, lu bisa ngomong dari Muriel. Termulai
itu anak buah Chief Davian berarti kan?
Betul sekali.
Yes, okay, I love it.
I will apa? I tadi yang bantu si S siapa?
I will say jadi.
Gua.
Rafael. In that case, gue nganggepnya si Rafael sama S di deket bocahnya, jadi gue tarik si Zephyl dikit gitu. Terus gue bisik-bisik nanya, should we ask if the kid feels okay or if he feels strange or?
I think. I don't know how we should, but maybe it's very hard to find like the opportunity to get the kid away from the father. If we are going to do that, I want to do it away from the father if possible. I don't know.
I just don't know how to, you know, interact with small.
Oh. Well, it just treat them like you normally would treat anybody else. Just maybe don't scare them. That's about it.
Si Balvan itu body language-nya kayak apa, bocah baru ketemu bocah, jadi sama-sama ngeliat-ngeliat doang, nggak berani ngomong, you know, kind of thing.
I mean, look at him. He is, I thing, armless at this point. At this point, I think he will be very interested in knowing you too.
Gue kayak ngintip.
Why don't we go together? Why don't we go together? Okay. And then I'll just guide like Balfan towards the child too, towards Ellen too.
Okay, while you have this happen, Rafael, what do you want to do?
Oh, enggak, gue cuma mau nanya ini sih, out of ini.
Oh, sih.
Do you think Rafael knows what is happening to?
Maybe S knows.
I mean, yeah, S knows.
Kalian, kalian berdua kan ya. I will say, S will tadi di kur 14 ya. I will say, gue langsung roll aja karena si S kan dia monster hunter ya, so she doesn't need to roll anything.
Oh yeah, that's true.
She doesn't roll anything. I think monster first dia kayak lihat kan dia ini ya prolif monster hunter yang udah jago gitu kan, anak emprentice-nya Pan Richter. At first, he thinks that if you think that this kid will be a werewolf, if that's what you're going to still think, no, it doesn't look it doesn't look like lycanthropy. Lycanthropy doesn't work.
Oh, okay.
Oh, it's just, not.
No, it looks like okay. It's kayak for the lack of better word, lihat dulu intelijen dia berapa. Kind of smart. For the lack of better word, katanya kayak lebih kayak ada. Ini aja ya, bahasa kita pakai bahasa modern lingo aja nggak apa ya, kayak ada mutasi genetik itu jadinya lebih ke arah situ, jadi bukan ikan dia saya langsung tahu dia bukan ikan tropi.
Okay.
I mean we don't know that but yeah.
Si S,
tapi lucunya sambil, ada karakteristiknya maksudnya
ya, paling sambil gini tuh dia sambil ini kan lagi periksa kan sama Rafael, si S kayak ngomong-ngomong kayak bisik-bisik gitu loh sih. Kalau Rafael kayak bilang weird, this is it almost looks like after he was revived there's something change in her, in his physiology. I mean I know that there is a spell that to resurrect people that can change you into other race, but I've never seen something like this that kinda alter your physiology. I've never seen something like this. I mean, that is true resurrection, of course, but it's kinda expensive through resurrection. And the other,
which is,
you know, I mean, and the other spells, it there is a lot of chance for you to be revived into other race. Maybe he will become an elf or anything else, but not like this. Not this. It's like change in his physiology. Sorry, terus dia kayak ngomong ke Dimitri. Sorry, I do not mean to menjelek-jelekan ini ya. Cuma I'm just making observation. Terus si Dimitri yang bilang, oh yeah, don't worry, I appreciate what you've done. So, do you think this is dangerous? Do you think this is not good for Alan? Terus Alannya kayak mukanya kayak bingung gitu, ini ngomongin apa orang dewasa gitu.
I think while SS, you know, I think I approach Alan. I mean Balfan approach, and like playing around with him, like making finger dolls or something.
Yeah.
Terus si Balfan di belakangnya awkward di.
Si Alan bilang itu, wow, are you made from stone? Are you hard?
Yes,
I mean you can knock him. Try knocking him.
Tuk tuk ow. Wow, you're made from hard. You are stone hard.
Yeah, he's super strong.
Don't be so stiff.
Yeah, I am one from nature.
Yeah.
What's your name?
You're very shiny.
And then, yeah, abis nanya-nanya gitu, he's like, Alan, do you need anything? Do you feel anything? Do you want us to do anything?
Not really. I mean, I was very sick, and then I slept for a very long time, And when I wake up, I do not... Well, I feel very refreshed. But, well, I kind of want to eat banana, you know?
But do I know what a banana is?
Yeah, I will say.
Probably has memories of banana before.
But I want to eat this fruit. I want to eat this banana, but my father doesn't know what it is.
How
you know banana?
Exactly. I don't know. Just want it. Terus pas dibilangin itu, bomom lu tau, oh banana lu tau pisang, ya pisang. But lu pas lagi dalam di Barovia ini pas dijelasin, kalian semua tuh gak pernah ada ngelihat pisang di Barovia.
I'm pretty sure that's tropical, man.
Makanya gak ada tau pisang apa.
Exactly, man.
Kalau lu bomong lu pernah ngeliat pisang di Darkon, tapi di Barovia tuh nggak ada pisang. Darkon tuh emang luas banget, Darkon, jadi emang ada area yang agak sedikit tropis gitu ya, ada tropik gitu. Kayak Fasad juga tahu pisang, cuma bukan dia nggak jar, dia tahu pisang tuh kayak, tapi nggak pernah ngeliat pisang beneran gitu loh.
He heard of pisang before, ya.
The curse of pisang. The curse of banana.
The curse of banana.
I'm
okay.
Do you want to eat that actually? Do you want to eat anything else or just the?
Not really. Terus sambil itu sampai garuk-garuk gitu.
I heard that you were previously sick.
Yes.
Don't you want to try exploring the outside?
Well, I want to, but my mother said that I'm too young to do that, so I need to stay inside so I will not get sick again.
Huh. Okay.
But I don't know, I think I want to explore, you know, I think climbing tree will be fun.
Yeah, I think you should too. Maybe not. You know, maybe just outside cracks. No, outside cracks. Outside your house, not outside cracks.
Yeah, there is this pine trees beside our home, but my mother is very, it's not fun. She doesn't want me to have fun. Terus si Dimitri bilang, oh no son. Itu karena kamu kan baru sembuh. Jangan main-main dulu, tunggu dulu. Kalau udah sembuh beneran dulu baru entah kamu boleh main ya. Oke, Dad. Janji ya kalau aku udah sembuh aku boleh manjat-manjat. Iya, Nak.
I think I close his ears if possible, like wait for him. Can I talk to Dimitri and say,
yeah,
how long do you wish to hide this from the citizens, from everybody?
I know that I cannot hide this for so long, but I just want to make sure that she's really safe. Because I don't want him to turn weird. You know, like the people in the AB.
Oh, okay. What's that?
Do we hear this
control? I think so.
Yeah, I think.
We're all in the room, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Then. Suaminya isinya nggak ada.
Okay, I will ask Rafael, I guess, and probably ask too. So, what do you feel like?
I mean, he's not an undead. That's for sure. I can tell you that, but I'm not sure. Like, I don't think this is your usual reviving spell. Yeah. Now there are changes.
He's not even like half people, right?
There are changes in his physique.
Yeah, there are some changes in his physiology, but well, I can understand why you, Burgomaster, you were cautious with how the magic works in this realm, because well, reviving is a divine magic, no? And then this place is is within the grasp of the dark power. Maybe it distorted the effect of the magic. We don't know. Maybe we should know more about it if we could meet the abbot.
Yeah, that's what I'm about to say. I mean, we are going there anyway. Maybe we can ask the abbot if it's bad for him or not.
Mr. Dimitri, before we leave, I guess, how long was it from the moment of his momentary passing and the abbot doing his miracle?
Oh, he... It only took... he died. And then the next day, the abbot came to prepare the burial, and then next day he revived him. Jadi ya, meninggal malam, besoknya paginya ketemu abbot, terus besoknya lagi baru di revive. Jadi dia like belum sempat dikubur
sebenarnya. Oh yeah, that's pretty fast.
Very curious now. Why is so Sanselin so generous to this abbot? And why is everybody afraid of him?
Well, we're not really afraid of him per se. It's more like he's a bit weird.
Everybody keeps saying that, sure.
he hasn't done anything to harm us. He helped us when he share the food that the abbey grows in their land, sorry, in their pekarangan, and they share it with us. And he offered to heal wounded hunters. Well, he also offered to pray for us, that's for sure. But he's just weird.
And how long has Alan been in this state?
Saya lupa, bentar. Catatan gue hilang. Minggu lalu gue bilang berapa lama.
Gue lupa masalahnya.
Let's just say
the sickness you mean.
Abis revive berapa hari?
I forget. Let's just say 3 days.
Oke. Okay. Ya. Yeah.
Maaf saya lupa ini ya.
Well, I guess that leaves us the abbey, I think.
Okay.
Yeah.
So don't forget that you want to do the lake, yeah.
Yeah, maybe yeah, just yeah. Passing for Raphael.
Yeah, I just want to see. I mean, there is something that's going to happen there.
It's already
before we go to, I mean, Lord Dimitri, do you know anything about a magic seed?
Magic
around cracks or anything? Magic orb seed? Magic seed, right? Magic seed. Yeah, magic seed, yeah.
I don't know.
Magic stone or seed? Gems.
Gems, magic. Well, I don't know. We're humble people here. We do not use magic. The only one that use magic is the abbot.
All right, thank you very much. That's all I need to know.
Okay, then ada yang mau tanya ke ada yang mau tanya lagi ke Bapak Dimitri?
Not from me for now.
If not, let's say kalian keluar.
Ini dari... ke lake dulu, baru ke Abby atau kebalik? Kalau dari rumahnya.
Yes, I mean. The klik dulu baru ke Abby.
Okay.
Lewat doang tapi.
Sebenarnya kan ini klik kan di sini. Walaupun kok nggak mau. Kliknya kan di sini nih.
Yap.
Itu kan. Walaupun itu nggak kelihatan ada jalan. Aja sih. Kalian bisa lewat sini jalan di sini. Kalian sini ada jalan gitulah buat naik ke atas.
Bos tembus jalan pintas.
Oke. Yeah sure. Let's go to the lake then.
Pas kalian keluar, I forget. Kalian keluar, ada guard kemarin. Saya lupa namanya dia siapa. Si bapak guard.
Anton.
Anton ya, thank you.
Anton, Victor, something.
Catatan saya hilang, maaf ya. Ada si guard Anton itu ketemu kalian, bilang, "Okay, then. Where do you want to go next? To the lake? To the lake we go."
Yes.
Kalian jangan ke lake.
Oh, kita di escort gitu.
Iya.
Kalau permintaan berumah sekarang kan di escort di mana kemana-mana kan. Kecuali kalau udah sampai Abby dia ditinggal itu.
I while we're walking, I would like to like choel Raphael's back.
Okay.
I was gonna do that.
Oh, you too. I was like, I'm just gonna say like, you think I remember a very familiar letters that I read before, you know, regarding something you asked, but you know. I think you asked about the house before. Maybe if you'd like, we can visit the house after we finish with the mission or something. But that's just.
Oh yeah, we can do that.
Yeah, I just want to tell you that, you know, I think we are all behind you, and maybe they don't know all the story yet. I mean, if you want to tell. So that everyone can be clear, but you know, it's up to you.
Yeah, terus abis lu ngomong gitu, like an ironically, si Balfan's like, "Oh, by the way, Raphael, about the lady, the story, do you know them?"
Yeah, I think that's my mother.
Terus gue yang stop jalan gitu. Roy. Okay.
But yeah, it's not. I don't really know much about her.
Are you sure? Or do you have?
Feeling? I mean, there is this letter that Zephiel gave me. I think I'm quite sure.
Oh.
I knuckle him like, "Who do you think is your dad, huh?"
Priorities, gitu ya.
It would be quite interesting, just you know.
Yeah, the biggest mystery of our game is who is Raphael's father? Yang human apa yang
Who's the father? Gitu.
I mean, in my opinion, the name Palsgrave is, you know, more edgier. Like, he sounds cooler in my head, but you know.
Semuanya tergantung nama yang.
I mean, gitu. I don't know. I don't feel like I have any half, like any elven blood. No, this is not Raphael. Oh,
are you sure? Are you sure? Yeah, like your bond with, you know, your I'm sorry, brother does not have anything to do with that. But okay, fine. All right, then.
No, we are not really related.
Yeah, I know, but you know, fates, smoshy, fatesy, whatever.
So, are we going to the AB now?
After the pool, after the lake.
I think you want to say to go to the lake.
Yeah.
I want to.
Yes.
Alright.
What's here in the lake?
Okay, there is a lake.
Anton, tell us.
There is a temple there.
So basically, you go to the north, northern part of this village, and then, this place is very. Ini ya dull color ya di sini kan ada snow salju, langitnya abu-abu kelabu bikin jadi galau gitu kan. But even under these gray skies, from afar you can see that this pool and somehow walaupun di sini bersalju dan segala macam, this pool at the north end of this village shimmers and sparkles. Very weird. And near its shore, you see this. There sits an old gazebo on the very verge of collapsing. Ada satu gazebo udah nggak urus banget itu. And then inside this gazebo, there is a wooden statue of a mournful, like bare-chested man. And its paint udah catnya tuh udah lopek-lopek, lotok-lotok nggak jelas gitu. Dan si wooden satunya tuh kayak lagi mendengar kayak ini loh, kayak patung Yesus Kristus yang itu yang open arms
gitu lah.
Ya okay. Gitulah. So wait, I think I have the visual for this. I should have this. I do have that. Okay, show to player.
Also like 5 minutes after our conversation, terus si Balvan masih yang Rafael, I'm sorry to hear that.
Oh no no, that's okay. It happened a long time ago anyway. If anything, I'm happy that I get to know where my parents, if there are two of them in the place, are buried.
Okay. So anyway, as you go near this pool, like as you can see, the water is kind of sparkle and shimmers, and as you go near this gazebo, this collapsing gazebo, and then you see this wooden statue of a bare-chested man, which kind of bare-chested man. You see that?
Look at it. There's another muscular man, bare-chested man.
Oh,
that's another one of your chiefs.
Oh my god.
I will incite the bare-chested statue.
So basically,
yes, please.
Okay, so basically, the worn man upon the statue surface. As you go closer.
Oh, bless you.
As you go closer, and Rafael, you can feel there's this. Kayak lo ngerasa ada kayak satu panggilan gitu buat datang ke arah this statue.
Oh shoot.
Yeah. And then you, as you go closer, you kinda see that this worn paint upon the statue surface begins to like glow in dim gold. Tuh-tuh agak bercahaya gitu. Bersinar. And you can see that even as its features begin to shift and change. Kayak slightly shift and change, and then you kinda hear si Anton kayak apa tuh, gua gak mau deket-deket gitu. What happened gitu kan ya,
and I cast detect magic. Like what's happening.
Okay, gua lanjut lagi ya. And then you can see that the edge mukanya kan, sini kan patungnya udah ini kan, udah agak udah worn gitu lah ya, udah dimakan waktu gitu. Suddenly lu liat kayak surface-nya mulai jadi kayak lebih mulai lebih mulus, terus lu kayak ngelihat kayak garis-garis mukanya gitu menghilang. Jadi lu lihat sekarang, you see this suddenly patungnya itu kelihatannya tuh kayak muka pria muda, probably like in his early or mid 20s. Lu lihat kayak patungnya yang sebelumnya warnanya udah butek klotok, tiba-tiba berwarna lagi, jadi ada warnanya, warna manusia biasa gitulah, warna manusia normal.
What?
Iya, mukanya jadi muka pria tadi, saya bilang tadi kan umur sekitar early or mid 20s. Rambutnya kan situ kan ini kan ya, awalnya kan rambut di pahat itu kan jadi kayak rambut beneran gitu, rambutnya warna hitam legam. Terus matanya juga sebenarnya matanya kelabu, agak tatapannya ramah gitu, kayak mata orang ramah gitulah, mata orang ramah, mukanya juga muka orang ramah, well muscled gitulah kan, perlu lihat waktu ini kan gambar fisiknya, well muscled. And then pas lu kayak ngeliat mukanya, only Zephiel, when you see this tattoo, tattoo-nya kan juga berubah. When you see his face, his face reminds you of Strat. Mukanya mirip banget muka Strat. But younger. But he looks younger. Rambutnya pendek. He looks way younger than Strat. Way warmer. Lebih friendly. Pas dia senyum sama kalian tuh, senyumnya tuh benar-benar senyum orang lo kan udah you've met a lot of people, and you can that insight lo berapa sih, kan ada yang insightnya pasti insightnya bagus ya, you can distinguish between people that smiles yang enggak ikhlas, yang ini dia kelihatan banget senyumnya senyum orang emang genuinely smiling,
genuine
smile, which is for you Xavier is kind of weird because the last time you see this face, mukanya start itu mukanya snarling ke lu gitu kan, mukanya marah. It's very unsettling to see Strat younger face but smiling very warmly at you all, kayak welcoming you all.
What the fuck, Raphael? What did you do? I cast detect magic.
I didn't do anything.
When you
cast we need to leave. I think
when you cast detect magic, I will say, for the lack of better words. Ya, gua nggak tahu juga school magic camp, but this you can feel like this is more like a divine magic gitu sih tuh. Let's just say divine magic gitu ya. Dan pas kayak itu dia bilang, si pria ini dia bilang, oh, do not be alarmed, friends, and welcome, Raphael, the servant of Ilmater. I welcome you here. I'm sorry if my appearance surprised you. This is not my intention to scare you. I just want to talk to you. Terus dia kayak ngelambain. Terus pas lo nengok si Anton udah kabur gitu, ditakut. Anton takut dia kena kabur.
Are you the morning lord?
No. I was when I was still alive, I was the servant of the morning lord. I was his cleric, but let me introduce myself. My name is Sergei Fonsarovich. I'm Sergei Fonsarovich. You can call me Sergei.
Are you
chief?
Do you have a twin brother?
No. I know that you're talking about my brother Strat.
He is my older brother.
Very older. We have decades apart. We are 20 years apart. And because of that, my brother was jealous of me. Although it is not my intention to bring misery to his life. It's just maybe my brother has lived for too long, and I am aware of what happened to him, of what happened to this land. This land used to be, I cannot really say better. When I was still here, when I was still alive, my brother came here as an invader. He conquered this he conquered this valley for our father's name, and then he declared himself the ruler of this valley, and then he got corrupted by a dark power. He was obsessed with Tatiana. And I can feel that she's no longer here, or at least the reincarnation, her current reincarnation is no longer in this
world. I'm sorry that happened.
Well, she will be reborn, because that is the nature of this. That is the nature of the curse of this land, to keep her coming back from the dead, and only for my brother to keep losing her over and over again. Well,
so it's like a cycle.
Well, I was hoping that probably you can help her to escape this realm, because there is no easy way for Tatiana's soul to break from this curse. But alas, she already passed away, and I would like to help you to escape from this realm, because I think you are not a native of this land.
And how are you going to help us?
I used to have a sword made from crystals, a sword that can emit sunlight. It was blessed by the Morning Lord himself. But upon my death, my brother destroyed the crystal and threw away the hilt. It would no longer work, but if you can find the hilt and then bring it here, I can give the essence of my power as a servant of the Morning Lord to reignite the sun that used to emit from my sword.
Is this the sword that you're telling me through my dreams?
Mm-hmm. Find my sword and I will bless it.
Well, where can we find it?
The last time, if I'm not mistaken, I
think we know that.
Yeah, we know.
Sorry, let me just check. Really check.
Where is the map?
Map with Rictavio.
There is.
The witch.
Correct.
She was not a witch, but Baba Lisaka used to be my brother's character.
Oh, nanny.
Yeah, she also used to mean, she used to have her own child. I mean, her own child. But they escaped Barovia. They escaped this realm.
That's a nanny.
They escaped our home countries, and then she became obsessed to raise my brother. Although I think, considering that Baba Lisaka now live in the ruin of Beres, I think there is a fallout. It happened after I died. But she is a very dangerous individual. She is a very highly skilled. She's a very skillful witch. You should be careful when you deal with her. Basically, rawan TPK itu. Jadi mau bilang gitu, hati-hati mati gitu.
No.
Anyway.
Yeah, we need to get this sword.
Itu swordnya basically bisa bikin vampir nggak bisa regen kan?
Something we can
kill.
It's the weakness kan?
Si S juga bilang yes, because if you want to kill true vampire, I mean, like we've seen what happened to Anastasia when we kill her, she turned into mist. And then she will go back to her coffin. And then when she was in the coffin, we can kill her there. But if we have sunlight, when she turned into mist, we can kill vampire. Truly kill them like that. Atau si bilang itu si Selga juga bilang, there's also something. Yeah, I know that my brother has become a vampire, the creature of the night. And then it is true that if you want to kill a true vampire like my brother or his wife's, pas ngomong his wife tuh si Sergei tuh kayak muka kayak, yeah, his wife, his wife, you will need son. But my brother was the dark power, the entity that my brother make a pact with. He would not let my brother to die.
So
if you kill him, I mean, you can escape from this realm. The mist will be gone only for a while, only temporary. But the mist will be back, and then he will be back.
So how is the kill him, kill him.
Yeah.
Yeah. There used to be this trio of adventurers that almost made it. They managed to slay Strahd, but only temporary, and then they tried to run away from the realm. But of course, he came back. The nature of his... I do not really understand the nature of his pact. All I know that it was sealed when he killed me. And before I died, my brother was obsessed with the knowledge in the Ember Temple. Ember Temple is the place where there used to be this order of wizards that used that temple to seal many dangerous artifacts. There are a lot of dangerous forbidden knowledge there, and then my brother was obsessed with it. Him and Exatanter, and also, if not mistaken, his guest from other realm as well. But I haven't met him because I am already dead. Vaslav is not here. If Vaslav is here, he will hear his patron chuckles.
Okay. So you are saying there should be something in the Ember Temple, yes, to tell us how to like fully cleanse the curse, something like that.
Exatanter is also still there in Ember Temple.
Yeah.
If you can talk to him. Maybe.
Is he a good person?
Is he dead?
I don't think
I'm
so.
I'm just going to tell you, Mr. Bom Bom. I've been dead for 7 centuries.
You wow. Dead and you look that good?
I'm a ghost.
No, he's
consider
not
me envious.
Well, Mr. Bombom, don't be like that. He also looks good. Yeah, I mean, he looks good. I like your tattoo.
You want to be my chief?
I like your tattoo.
Oh, you like my hair as well?
Yes, it's very it looks like fire. So yeah.
Okay, who makes that sound?
Bombom. Bombom.
I will just collapse. I'll just collapse. For like 2 seconds.
Terus esnya kayak, loh Bom, lo kenapa? Gitu. Yeah. Senang ya Bom dipuji ya.
Never in his like short 2.5 years.
Yeah. Short 2.5 years.
Yeah. And then you can see,
has,
I mean,
has
I think
he been
probably from Bom, it's long. It's his long two years long lifespan.
Yep.
Yeah. Dan pas dia ngomong itu, si Sarian pas ngomong itu kayak mukanya senyum-senyumnya kayak yang bener. Mukanya tuh bener-bener yang, ya kok gue suka tato lo gitu. Mukanya kayak bener, kelihatan bener-bener bukan lip service doang, dia bener-bener itu. Kelihatannya genuine gitu ngomongnya. Gitu, so.
Okay. Anything else you'd like to tell us, Sir Sergi?
Man, you've already found my brother's journal. My brother's tomb.
Yeah.
I mean, basically his diary. You can find a lot of, you can find informations in there. Maybe you can find the nature of the pact in the tomb as well.
Got
of
it.
Of course, I will fully recommend for you to find my mother's holy symbol.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Holy symbol of every kind.
Got it.
Yeah, I mean, if you have
anything you know about the Fates, about the Fates, the three ladies.
The Fates. It is a very sad story, actually. When my brothers conquered this land, and he drove away the forest folk deeper into the forest. There is this rituals in my family that was passed from generation to generation. a ritual to, well, basically, it's just, you know, like a short rituals, just for formality, for us to make the land ours. But because, well, it turns out my brother is a practitioner of magic as well. When he did that, he desecrated the Fane's shrines. And after that, when he bound the land to him, he really did that. So that's why he can control the land. He can. That's basically what happened to Beres. He drowned the whole village just because he wanted to be like
he
that.
He can do that?
He can do that.
Oh my god.
When Tatiana passed away in his grief, he made the plants wither. And he can call storm. He can create avalanche. Just because he wanted, because the land is bound to him.
Strat is a druid. Now we know.
Part of
no, that's not in track.
Oh, bohong.
Bohong.
He can call storm. So basically, if you fight him outside of his castle, you will be fucked. Dia bisa aja lagi, basically. If you fight him like outside his castle, dia bisa aja tahu-tahu panggil kalian disambar petir. Ini basically lair actionnya di semua tempatnya is like he has lair action.
Barovia is his lair.
Yeah, Barovia is his lair.
Jesus.
I mean, he's not the only one who can call lightning.
Yep.
Yes. Yeah,
but can you call lightning without spending spell slot?
Hey.
Bisa, bisa spell slotnya sekali yo.
I have any spell slots.
Gak mau kalah.
Setiap round call lightning setiap round. Edit kayak ini kan round turn order 20. Lightning.
So no opinions about the fans at all? Like the fans, are they like?
Oh.
Are they?
They were amicable. They have amicable relationship with the Morning Lord.
The okay. Morning Lord gotcha. Mourned
their disappearance, but we cannot. I cannot sense them. I believe that they are still here in this land, but because their shrine was desecrated, and then people already forgot about them because of Strahd's influence. So that's why they were weak, and because they are weak, and also they tried to hide from Strahd. Even I cannot sense them anymore.
Gotcha. All right. That's all from me.
Also, well, a word of cautions. If you want to go to the AB, the abbot has been here for a very long time. And for someone that holy to be in a cursed place like this, he is I cannot say that he has lost his visions. He still believes what he does is. He still has a good heart. He still has a good intention. But like I said, for someone holy that has been spending too much time in a corrupted land, dia udah agak sedikit ada kedistorsi. There's something distorted about his personality. Just word of caution.
Okay.
Intinya udah kelamaan di sini jadi agak dia
korup.
But you said he's been here for a long time, like he's immortal. Sorry.
He can live a very long time. Some race can live a very long time.
Okay, got it.
I know that humans can only live for 70-80 years, but some race can live for 500 years.
Oh, ooh. Is he an elf too?
What race is the abbot?
An elf, I assume. I don't know.
Love life, a race that can live very long. That's what he say.
Oh, Sergei.
Tanggung ah Sergei.
But he is the servant of the Morning Lord.
Yeah, I mean, what I heard so far is that he's very generous, even though everyone's been saying he's weird.
I haven't met him in person yet. But just take my words as a, well, this is a word. Silakan ambil informasi yang saya kasih ini dan jadikan.
Take it with a grain of salt.
Yes, this is just a word of caution for me. He is still the servant of the Morning Lord. He still believes that what he does is correct, because he was here to help. He is here to help people, and he's still trying to do that.
Okay. Anything else?
Ada yang mau tanya lagi ke Sergei nggak?
I'm good.
No, for now. I think we need to retrieve the sword first.
Yeah.
After we visit the Abbey, of course.
Okay. If you seek consuls, I will still. Nah, if you seek my consul, I will be here. I am bound to this place. But. Of course, Sir Raphael, please bring my sword here, and then I will aid you to with your mission.
The vanquish. Yes, I'll do that.
Do you like want us to bring something next time aside from the sword, or
like tea maybe?
Oh, well, tea. I do not have. I'm a corporeal.
Yeah,
I only have a corporeal body. I don't have a material body, so I cannot drink tea, unfortunately. But thank you for your offer, Mr. Balvan. That's very nice.
It's just like, you know, my apparently, I don't know what to call him. He's like, do this for me, you know, and like, you know, I don't know. That people sometimes ask for things. So.
No, I'm content here. All my needs is being fulfilled by the Morning Lord himself. I'm at peace.
Like jeez. Yeah. Right then, let's go. I'm so eager.
Terus udah kayak dia menghilang lagi.
Wait, so the Morning Lord
with the Abbey
still exists.
Oh yes, the Morning Lord.
I think
the Morning
so.
Lord, yes. Lo ngomongin sebelum dia menghilang atau setelah dia menghilang?
Setelah aja deh, setelah.
Okay. Dia muncul lagi, jadi Morning Lord. They want to hear about the story of our Lord and Savior, Morning Lord. Okay, so sekarang si Anton udah menghilang, dia takut ngeliat ada hantu gitu kan. So I will say you will go to the ini.
AB.
So the AB? Okay, let's go to the AB. Bentar, ganti musik. Bloop. Sebentar. Oke aja. Okay then. So you the road from the village to the AB is uphill gitu kan, naik ya. Yeah. Lagunya agak sedikit solemn sedikit, sebentar. Gua ganti ini aja. kalian ini jadi jalannya menanjak naik ke atas. And then above them you can see kayak makin ke atas tuh kayak ada kabut-kabut gitu kan. And di atas kan dari sampai sini kalau lu udah bisa ngeliat kayak ini kan ada ebinya di atas. Kalian naik ke atas. And you can see that like there's a light dusting of snow covers the tree and the rocky earth. And you see this. Mana ya? Abbey of Saint Markovia. Okay, so this is what you see. Pas kalian naik ke atas, jadi kurang lebih kayak gini ya bentukan abbey-nya. Walaupun kalian belum masuk juga sih.
Oh.
Okay, so.
Lah itu ada orang.
So basically the gravel, you can see that there's this pas naik itu ada.
Di mana orang?
Atas tower.
Itu
atas
dua tower. Orang yang jaga itu.
Oh, iya. Yeah. Oh, iya. Yeah.
So, okay, so ini, so basically okay, the gravel road passes between two small stone outbuildings. Terus lu sekarang lihat your path is blocked by these iron gates attached to the outbuilding. So basically I'm just going to bring you to the map.
Yeah.
Yes, also this
map. New map.
The map is very big.
Oh boy. Oh my god. Ooh. That's a lot of black blocks.
That's a big map, like I said. That's just sekarang kalian daerah-daerah sini ya. Boleh bawa token kalian sini.
Oh, token masing-masing? Yeah. Oke.
Okay. Token masing-masing aja. Very big.
Oke.
Okay. Big place, baby.
Oh, very small token.
Iya. Yeah. Berarti ini satu.
Gua kira apa,
satu bakal grid sekotak berapa ya. Feet ini?
Oh my god, that's 10 feet squared.
10 feet squared. Iya. Kenapa sih
bikinnya
harus gede-gede gitu loh? Kan berantemnya susah.
Gitu. Di Porsche mestinya.
Okay, so the iron gates, you can see that there is this two tower gitu kan, ada dua tower gitu, terbuat kayak dari sini tuh lu oh gua salah deh, harusnya lu bisa ngeliat ke dalam situ, ya udahlah nggak apa-apa. Lupa situ nggak ada itu, nggak ada ininya, jadi harusnya segini. Harusnya kalian nggak bisa lari, tapi ya sudahlah ya, kesalahan DM.
Jadi it's ada fine.
Kesalahan DM adalah berkah untuk player. Yeah. So you can see dan depan itu lu lihat ada satu iron gates attached to this two tower. It has like this rusty hinges. Udah pas kalian datang tuh kayak ketiupkan sih kan tinggi ya, ada angin-angin tuh kayak udah krik karena udah karatan gitu tertepamin. They appear to be unlocked. Dan pas kalian coba masuk ke dalam itu kan, jadi kan iron gates itu kalian bisa ngeliat ke dalam gitu kan, ke dalam. Jadi basically yang tadi dari iron gates itu lo bisa ngeliat dalamnya, kira-kira yang tadi gua kasih visual tadi itulah dalamnya seperti itu. Gua bukain dikit aja berarti ya, karena kalian kan bisa mengintip dari dalam sini ya. Ini sekarang kalian belum bisa ngeliat ke dalam ini ya, ke dalam towernya ini ya, karena dia tuh pintunya tuh di dalam.
Closed off gitu harusnya.
Ya. Di luar tuh nggak kelihatan ada apa-apanya.
Well, I will enter straight ahead.
Okay, you can move your token to go inside. Bentar. Esmeralda, come here, baby.
Gertnya nggak menyapa kita, Rin.
Bentar ya, pas kalian masuk.
Ini garisnya hidden atau in the tower?
Jadi itu towernya ini tuh. Sebentar.
Mirip kayak cubicle tower, satpam gitu nggak sih jadinya?
Cubicle satpam, cuma
cubicle
tuh
satpam.
Nggak salah sih, jadi dia tuh nggak ada ini ya, nggak ada jendela gitu keluar. Jadi pas lo masuk sini, bom lo baru lihat, oh sini tuh ini apa namanya, ada pintu buat ke dalam itu, cuma itu doang, opening bukaan buat dari dalam kamarnya. Jadi kalau kalian mau masuk
I will peek inside.
Oke, sebentar ya.
Hello.
Sekarang kamu lihat sekalian tuh pas kalian masuk situ, bom-bom. View to the great, you can see the stone abbey stands quiet. Its two wing are joined by 15 foot high curtain wall. So pas kalian ke situ berarti, oh kalian sebenarnya gini ya. Let me.
Boleh tinggi banget ya?
Gue buka lagi ya, jadi ini tuh.
Ini gereja
pas. Ini gereja soalnya, makanya besar ya pak. Reveal. Itu.
Why?
Oh boy.
Bangunan
this is unnecessarily big.
I know, right?
Iya.
Gue juga makanya nih. Ini gue juga udah sedih gitu. Nah. Jadi di sini tuh kalian inilah. Gua kasih lihat ini aja kali ya. Ya, jadi basically kalau kalian situ kan yang hitam-hitamnya itu, bangunan AB-nya tuh yang hitamnya gitu lah.
Tembok basically kan jadinya.
Tembok itu batas temboknya. Ini gede amat sih nih tempatnya, kesel deh gua. Itulah. Gitu biar kalian bisa lihat kira-kira scale bangunan seberapa. Gua sep.
Oke. Okay.
Gila sih.
Lagi. This abbey is too fucking big, man. I get it.
That's what she said.
What?
Yes, okay. So, basically kalau dari sekarang tuh jadi gue tau sih belum kelihatan ya, tapi kalau tadi lo lihat dari gambarnya. Mungkin gue nggak tau sih lo tahu apa nggak sih. Yang jelas tuh bangunan tuh ada dua wing gitulah. Kalau lihat gambar itu ada dua bangunan, terus di tengahnya tuh dijoin sama ada jalan. Jadi kan lo lihat kan ada ini kan, ada tadi lo bilang ada dua guards di atas tembok. Nah itu temboknya tuh kayak buat ngejoin antara bangunan satu ke bangunan dua. Jadi bangunan, jadi abbey-nya ada dua bangunan.
Ada.
Gitu pas lu nengok ke garis itu, bom-bom. Terus juga liat lu di bangunan dia itu ada kayak cerobong asap gitulah di wing yang sebelah utara. Jadi anggap aja ini wing utara. Sebelah sini
di atas
yang selatan ya, jadi di bintang tuh kayak ada cerobong atap naik ke atas, which is terus pas kayak masuk situ, lu nggak lihat ini gansnya di mana, terus pas lu lagi ngintip situ bom-bom, jadi kan dia pintunya dia tuh nggak ada gate, ini kan gate towernya tuh nggak ketutup gitu sebenarnya sih dia. Dia tuh jadi cuma kayak opening gitulah, kayak ada lubang kayak daun enggak daun pintu yang enggak ada daun pintu yang enggak ada daun pintunya gitu ya. Saya tidak tahu bahasa orang awam
ya. Cuma archway ya, gitu.
Ambangnya gitu. Doang, ambang pintu doang.
Dan pas lo ngintip di situ bom-bom yang ke arah lo kan yang atas berarti yang ngintipnya. Yang atas itu whoops. Lo lihat di dalam situ ada sesosok humanoid-ish creature. Kelihatannya sih they look like they are sleeping under piles of animal fur. Pipi lo berapa?
14.
Dua.
14 ya. Yeah.
Pipi kanan, pipi kiri. Pipi kanan. I mean, can be more if you count other cheek
at once.
Pas lu liat sebelah situ, lu ngeliat ada yang aneh kan, dia kan kayak tidur gitu kan, pakai selimut. Kelihatannya sih kayak orang sih ya, orang. Cuma lu liat kayaknya ada kayak kuping ini, apa namanya? Salah satu kupingnya itu. Kayak kuping ini loh, kayak kuping anjing serigala gitu, udah kayak kuping serigala kalau udah komputer, kayak kuping serigala tuh satu-satu keluar dari, jadi kan dia pakai selimutnya kan sampai sini gitu, tapi lo liat kupingnya di sebelah sini tuh kupingnya kuping kayak kuping segitiga kayak kuping serigala gitu.
Oke.
Lagi bobo gitu kayak datang tuh.
Gitu. I will tap somewhere.
Yang sini mau di situ juga nggak? Yang satu lagi mau dicek?
Dalam I guess, yeah, we could.
I'm not checking. I'm only looking at Bob Bob like concerned, and I'm just looking around.
Hello.
Si S kayak ngintip ke dalam gitu kan, ngintip ke dalam. S tuh pipinya berapa sih? Bentar. S should, your pipi should be good.
He has only.
I forget exact pipinya sekian. Aduh, udah. Aku sih karakter sheet, hobi. Ini dia nggak tahu sih. Iya, pipinya bagus. Pas dia lihat ke dalam tuh ada satu sosok juga orang lagi tidur gitu pakai ini, pakai sama lagi selimutan gitu. Tapi dia kan kalau siang satu itu kan tiduran terus selimutnya begini ya. Kalau dia tuh kayak posisinya duduk, selimutannya tuh kayak melindungi badan dia gitu. Dia lagi gini posisinya. Dan si S ngeliat tangannya kan begini. Dia nggak bisa mukanya. Cuma dia lihat tangan kirinya itu bersisik.
Oh shoot.
Bersisik kayak sisik kadal. Tangan satunya lagi berbulu, ada bulu warna abu-abu.
What are these people, man?
Bulu abu-abu terus lagi tidur.
What the fuck?
Pas si SP kayak bilang, what the fuck gitu kan. Apaan nih? Si Momo udah keburu masuk kayak hello. Lu lihat si yang tadi tuh buka mata. Pas dia buka mata, sebenarnya ini kan dia buka mata kayak bumbuk gitu, kayak alarm. Lu lihat pas liputan jatuh, sosok ini adalah mukanya sebelah kanannya muka manusia, sebelah kirinya kayak anjing gitu. Jadi dia punya snout, punya moncong anjing kayak serigala, kuping sebelah sininya kayak kuping serigala juga. Mata sebelah sininya masih muka manusia. Terus dia karena dia alarm, dia berdiri kayak ngambil shovel gitu. And then you also notice that badan otot-ototnya manusia, kakinya kayak kaki serigala gitu. Sama lu lihat di bawah bawahnya. And then you see di ini di bawahnya ada ekor. Tapi ekornya kelihatannya lebih kayak ekor apa namanya itu? Kayak kelihatannya kayak ekor kedelai.
Kedelai.
He's a soy boy.
Donkey.
He's a soy boy.
Oh, that was good.
Donkey. Terus dia sambil pegang ini. Sambil pegang shovel dia bilang, "Who are you? Why are you here?"
Me is Bom Bom. Nice to meet you. Are you okay?
Terus dia bilang, "Me is Bom Bom. Nice to meet you. This is where we're going to leave the session."
Hey. Oh. Hey.
Jam 11, bos. Dia disehat, bos.
Gak berasa.
Well, at least we played.
At least you play. I'm hoping that probably next week kita udah bisa tackle AB. Tapi kalau kita main
nice, let's go.
AB before the, next year please.
kita kelarin AB tahun ini ya, biar next year kita udah.
Yes.
We any percent speed run this shit.
Biar kita apa awal tahun langsung naik level kan.
Iya, paling enggak awal tahun naik level kita udah bisa mesti ke beres paling
kali ini.
Nice. Bisa beres. Semua beres.
That's it guys, thank you for playing. I hope next week we'll play.
Yes, we should.
Kita explore AB yang kegedean ini.
Let's go.
Kita banget kesel gue WP-nya berat. Oke, okay, I will see next week. Yang mau apa sih? I don't know. Check our Discord, I guess. Join our Discord, pemain D&D, I don't know. But that's it guys, thank you, bye-bye.
Check the description,
bye.
Like, comment, and subscribe.
Ya, itu dia lupa.